instead of using that conclusion to help find the airplane, you say, well, I've got this conclusion, now all your facts line up, and you twist the facts back just a little bit, or you over-exaggerate, or you try to find something that's in there to justify the, justify your head that, yeah, that's the right conclusion. But you have to bring yourself back from that, forget about your past history, forget about what you've known or learned from previous investigations even. At some point, you have to just imagine or understand the unfathomable, what could have happened in the need of that.
David Gallo, the idea, you know, this 120 pieces of debris that we talked about at the top of the program that was spotted in an Enterprise satellite image has not been, the people are on the scene and both the ship, naval vessel, and all the multiple aircraft, they have not found any of these pieces of this 120. How significant do you think this is, this idea of there being some sort of open debris here?
Well, I think it's significant because there is some feeling that it must have come from the same place. So whether it's the ship or the aircraft, it's hard to say until I actually pick up a piece. And I find it hard to hope against the hopes and prayers of the family and loved ones of the passengers. So you know, in some part of me wants it not to be from the plane, the other part of me wants it to, you know, get on with the investigation.
David Gallo, the idea of it being together, A, indicating the source, or just given the nature of currents in this region, it could just be a nature of the way garbage collects in the sea around.
Yeah, well, and it does. But I think that's an advantage, because now we know where it's gathering. So if there was debris in the area, those currents of debris didn't end up breathing, it was from A, very well.
Hirsch. Hirsch, stop it.
The statistics of having